Hi children, I hope you are all doing well. Listen to your parents, stay at home, please don't go outside, always clean your hands, stay healthy, okay? And today we are going to discuss the types of operating system. It is session 7, the same chapter, operating system. Before getting into the topic, let us just review what we saw in last class. So last class, we saw about the last function of an operating system. What is that? Yes, it is file management. How you will create the folder, how you will rename it, how you can delete the file. All those things we saw it in last class. Okay, so you know what is a folder, what is a file, how it can be stored, who's allocating the memory to the file, and how the file will be deleted from the memory, how the memory is deallocated, and who's controlling these operations. Now you know who's doing that, right? Okay. Now we'll see what are the contents for today's class. Okay. So in this session, we are going to see types of operating system. Okay, so the first one, introduction to the types. Second, single user operating system. That can be divided into two topics. One is single task, another one is multitask. Understood, children? Once again, I'll tell you, in this class, we are going to cover the single user operating system. And that single user operating system can be of two types. One is single task, another one multitask. Are you ready, children? Okay. So, now you know what are the types of operating system. So, we already know the uses and the categories of operating system which is used in a computer. So, now can you say what type of operating system is in your computer? So nowadays, we mostly use Windows operating system, right? So many operating system we have, and those operating system functions under different categories. So those categories we are going to see in this chapter. Understood? So Windows, Linux, Unix, Mac OS, and all those operating system has something to do with the types of operating system. Okay. So why do we need types of operating system? Now you know what is operating system, what are the types of operating system, and why we need the types. Why can't we have only one type of operating system? There is some reason behind that. Operating systems were developed to accommodate all the different purposes. So it is not only satisfying one purpose, it is satisfying multiple purposes of using computers. You can take printout, you can save some document, you can listen to songs, you can watch the video. So many categories you can see in this operating, means in the computer. Those categories can be managed by operating system. And having just one type of operating system would not be enough to deal with all the different functions that are needed in different cases. What it says here exactly? Having just one type of operating system, it is not enough at all for me. So, to do multiple functions, to do multiple programs in different situations, I need the types of operating system to work on. So, for each and every functionality, I need different type of operating system. Okay, so only the same operating system cannot satisfy all the functionalities in the computer. So according to that, we have some partitions. So like that, here for multiple programs or functions in different situations, we need types of operating system. Got it? Okay, so by looking at the picture, what do you see? A man is sitting at table a lamp, then a computer system. So look at the computer system. There is only one screen is working on. Is working only on one screen. Is executing only one program. He is having one computer and only one function is going on at present. So what do we call this? A single person is working on single task. So those who are using the computer, we call him as user. You understood now? Tell me the topic now. Single user, single task. This operating system is called single user, single task operating system. Now let us see what is single user operating system. So a single user is doing only one function at a time is called single user operating system. He is performing only one action at a time, one program at a time. He is executing only one process at a time. That we call it as single user, single task OS. So it is specially designed to manage the computer. That computer can be processed successfully to perform only one action at a time. So we call it as single user, single task. So for example, we have here MS DOS, disk operating system, and POM OS. What is this POM? Do you know what I mean? What is mean by POM? What is POM? POM means the middle portion in your hand. That is called palm, where you can hold something and work on. Not really working, you can hold something inside your hand. That portion is called palm. So here I have just given an example for operating system. For single user operating system is palm OS. Since you can hold that type of operating system computer in your hand, you can call it as palm handled computers. So desktop you know, computer you know, but what is mean by palm handled computer, where you can hold that computer in your hand and you can work on? That is called palm handled computer. How it looks like? So you are eager, means interested to see that type of operating system, right? You might have seen computer, laptop, notebook, tab, mobile, everything. So what is this palm handled computer? How does it look like? It looks like this. It looks like a mobile phone where you can hold it in your hand and you can perform all the tasks which you performed in the computer. Understood? Okay. So this is called palm handled computer. Now I'm going to ask you, what type of operating system this picture is. So you are going to guess what type of operating system is. What type of operating system is used in this? Can anyone say? Yes, it is POM operating system, where you can use this in POM handled computers. Right? Okay. Very good. Now you are going to see the second part of your single user operating system is multitask. So far you have seen single task. One person will do one task at a time. So single user multitask. What does it mean? One person is going to do multiple actions here. Okay, what he is doing here? What is he doing? He has two computer systems here. One and two. Simultaneously is working on both the computers. So this we call it as multitasking. So we are going to see what is single user operating system with multitask. Okay. So this operating system will allow a single user to operate several programs at the same time. This operating system is going to allow you to do multiple tasks at the same time. Oh, multiple tasks I can do at the same time. I have only two hands and I can perform only one hand with the computer. and that can do only one process in the computer. But how can it say multiple programs at a time? Yes, you can do it. I will tell you how and how it is processed in computer also. So we'll first you should know what are the examples for single user operating system with multitask. So for a single user, single operating system is palm handled computer, and for multitasking we are all performing multitasking nowadays. So for this generation you are using Windows by Microsoft company, Mac OS by Apple. Okay, so for example, I'm going to give you an example for this. A person who is just writing an email to his friend, simultaneously he is also giving the printout a simple document. While typing the mail, he is sending the document for printing process. So let me put it in a simple way. You got an email with some attachment. You got a photo or you got some letter. So that letter, you are downloading it in your computer. So while downloading it in your computer, you are already listening to some songs in Google. You will be listening to the songs and simultaneously you are taking the printout. You can download the file from internet. Understood? Okay. So how does that work? You know already, you can minimize the task and you can open the new task and you can perform. Whenever you want to go back to that performance, you can just again minimize the tab and you can work on that particular document which you want to do. Now you all know one person how we can do multiple tasks, right? Okay, let us see some example for multitasking. So most of them are using this type of operating system only nowadays in computers, laptop, desktop, browsing centers, everywhere, because they have to do multiple process at a time to finish it, and the timing is very important for everyone. They don't want to waste the time, so they want to complete it while doing some process. So that's how this operating system become popular among everyone. Can you see this person? What is he doing? By looking at the picture, I'll give you just 10 seconds. Think about it. What is he doing? This is a Word document. This is a calculator. And this is some browsing softwares. So now this three arrows are indicating him. He is performing on three documents. How? While he is typing some mathematical formula in this Word document, you want to calculate some process and you want to check with the result in Google. So likewise, he is using all three tasks at a time. That is called computer multitasking. Understood, children? Okay. Now you are going to guess what type of operating system is. Look at the picture. What is he doing? So previously you saw one picture for single user, single OS, and here he got multiple tasks, and look at the window here, computer screen. He has 1, 2, 3. Three windows are opened. So he is working on three processes at a time. So this all multiple process, multiple tasks is opened and only one person is performing all the tasks. What do we call that? Tell me. Single user, multiple task. Okay. Single user, multitask operating system. Once again, guess the operating system. Think carefully. Yes, your guess is right. Single user, multitask operating system. Right, children? Okay. Now we are going to recall the concepts whatever we saw today. What is single user multitask? They enable a single user to do several tasks. That is called single user multitask. And again, it's a true or false question. The POM operating system is an example of single user, single task OS. Is it true or false? True, right? Okay. Now I have a homework for you. So you are going to predict this picture, what type of operating system it is, and you are going to write an explanation for this type of operating system in your classwork. So clearly look at the picture and tell me what type of operating system it is, and after guessing your type, you have to write about that type few lines in your classwork. And after writing that, please do take a screenshot and share it in Google Classroom. We are going to see in detail about multi-user operating system. Okay, are you ready, children? Okay, so let us get into the topic directly. So introduction part, multi-user operating system. In the name itself, you can imagine multiple users can perform in the same system. How it is possible? One system can be occupied by only one person, right? So how does the system can be shared by all the people? Like two or more users can share the same system. How is it possible? Yes, it is possible. So you can also share the system to another person. Okay, so let us see how is he doing. So these are all the operating system comes under the category multi-user operating system. Unix, Windows, Linux, and this operating system comes under multi-user operating system. Okay, now let us see what is exactly multi-user operating system. Multi-user OS allows many different users on different computer to access a single system. As I told you, one system will be shared by multiple users and they can use multiple system at a time. Okay, let me give you one example here. Have you all gone to browsing centers? Due to some emergency situation, if you don't have internet package or if you don't have a system at home, you might have gone to browsing centers, or you might have seen some of your friends or some other person go to browsing center. How does the browsing center looks like? So many systems will be kept in order. So one by one, they will be using the system and they will leave the browsing centers. Right. So how do you think all the system gets the internet? So each computer doesn't have its own internet package. Only one person who is the owner, he will have the control of all the system, and that particular owner system internet package will be shared to all the system so that he can have the control of all the systems under his hand. So he is sharing it to multiple systems so that multiple users can perform at a time using that single system. Now you understood? So here many users can take advantage of the computer's resources simultaneously. They are utilizing it. They can avail the internet. They can avail the network. So one network can share multiple systems. So Airtel company. We have Airtel company, and that company is going to build a tower in your street. So that tower, is it belongs to only one person? No, that Airtel network tower belongs to more than 50 or 60 users in that particular area. It is sharing that particular single system to multiple users. So all of them are availing the internet and they are using it, right? So like that, your multi-user operating system is just taking the advantage of computer's resources simultaneously. So allows multiple users to access the computer system at the same time. That is the meaning of multi-user operating system. You understood? For example, what are the example operating systems given for multi-user? Linux, Unix, and Windows. Got it, children? Okay, now you know what is multi-user operating system. So now you are going to tell me what is going on in the picture. A man is sitting here and a woman. So both of them are just doing their process. So he is performing some actions and she is doing some actions. Both of them are using here. Can you see this? So both of them are using only one particular internet modem. So these both of them are accessing the single system and performing their own functionalities. So they're doing their own actions, they're doing their own task. Okay, so to perform their own task, they are utilizing a single resource. She is also availing the advantage of that particular resource and performing her job. Now you understood what is multi-user operating system? Okay, so now I'm going to tell you still in detail about multi-user operating system. You saw some samples. Now you're going to see what is multi-user operating system. So here each person is called as user. Those who are using the systems, we call them as users. Okay, and these users all have their own individual system. Each one will do their own task and they are using their own system. Okay, and what is it kept in between? Can you see that? So each one has single access to that particular resource. What is that system? Can you look into that? So a single resource is utilized by multiple users. They are using the single resource for their own advantage, right? So they are accessing it through network. Here, can you see these all routers in between? So this particular things we call it as network, a collection of systems connected together through a single network. Got it? So this is multi-user operating system. Multiple person can use at a time. So here also the same, user 1, user 2 and 3, 4, 5. So all of them are using only one particular resource, which is used by the user owner. He is a owner. He is giving access to all the person to access and perform their task. They are doing their own particular task and finishing it and moving on. Okay, now you know what is multitask. You know what is single task. Here it is multi-user operating system. Single user is different, multiple user is different. Multiple persons are utilizing the system and doing the multiple tasks at a same time. That is called multi-user operating system. Understood, children? Okay. Now, multi-user OS, the operating system takes care of all the requirements of the various users in a balanced manner. So, okay, once a single user is occupying the resource, what happens there? What happens? So that particular resource will be occupied by one person. Other users will be waiting. And if what if they all need the internet on perform at a time? So that the operating system should see the availability and give the resources to all the process. So at that time, what is he going to do is, he is dividing equal partitions to all the users and it is allocating so that the internet is shared between all the users, so everyone can use it according to the same speed. Example, 100 kbps and another system also 100 kbps. The same speed will be maintained for all the system since it is shared by operating system. So one cannot use it so high and one cannot perform it so slow. So this is the way the operating system shares and multiple users can occupy the resource at a time. Also, it ensures that each of the programs being used as a separate and sufficient resource. So it will make sure that no system, that means no user can create a problem in between. If one system creates a problem and if it gets corrupted, that shouldn't be affected to all the systems. When one person network is failure, what happens to the another person? So even that network will be failure when it is connected together, right? But operating system makes sure that shouldn't happen, so that it is just dividing according to the resource availability. So here it ensures that each of the programs being used as a separate and sufficient resource, so that a problem of one user doesn't affect the entire community of users. Now you understood? So it doesn't affect the other community of users, so that each one can have different fault that will be rectified by operating system. Okay, so now you are going to tell me what type of operating system is and what it does. What does this picture tell you now? What type of operating system is? Multiple users, a single server, a single owner. Multiple users, a single system. We call it as multi-user operating system, right? Okay, now you all know multi-user operating system and what are the types of that particular going. See, for example, in your school, let us consider a computer laboratory. Okay, a computer laboratory has 30 systems, so that the 30 systems will be connected through local area network, which we call it as LAN. In that laboratory, somewhere in the corner, you can see one hub, which looks like multiple connections will be connected to a single system. So that particular system, we call it as server, and that server gives you all the internet facilities, not only internet facilities, a sharing options also is possible for you. So that particular internet will be shared to all 30 systems. You can use that particular system without having particular system's modem, or we can say individual modem is not at all necessary for the systems, since it is being shared by some device. We call it as server. Understood, children? In your lab, there will be some hub. How it looks like? The hub looks like multiple wires or cables will be connected to that system, and that system we call it a server, and that server gives you the connection. Once you switch on the server, all the system which is connected together will be working status, will be in working status, so that now you can avail the systems and perform your tasks. That is called multi-user operating system, which uses the same system at a time. All 30 students will use the systems at a time. That is called multi-user operating system, right? Now you are very clear about multi-user operating system. Okay, now let us recall what is multi-user operating system. So first I'm going to ask you, define multi-user OS. How will you define? So by looking at the picture, you can guess multiple users are using a single system. That is multi-user operating system. They share the same task at one time. I can give you one more example also. So one of your cousin or your sister or brother will be working in IT company. So in IT company, there will be so many projects. In future, even you might do some projects, okay? And one project will not be allocated to one person. It will be allocated always to a team, okay? All of them should do as a teamwork. So we call it as project management. At that time, they will just share only one program as multiple tasks. Each person will take one function, and they will write a program for that. Finally, all the functions will be merged together and it will form as a single project. So all of them are sharing the same task, but in different functionalities. Finally, it is going to be only one project. Okay. So likewise, one server, there is a control, only one system, and others or users can make avail of that particular system and they can finish their task. Understood? Okay.